Hey, howdy, hey, welcome to or welcome back to my channel. For tonight's video, I'm going to be reacting to Drag Race Holland episode 3. So if that sounds good to you, make sure to like this video, comment down below what you think of this episode, and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. My birthday's in 5 days, so go ahead and give me that subscribe. And without further ado, let's get this video started. Zoop! Alright, first things first, I want to include a special little shout out I got from Rock'em Sakura, so I'm going to go ahead and put that in now.
Hey everybody, it's me, Rock'em Sakura from the cast of season 12 of RuPaul's Drag Race. Make sure you go down and you subscribe to Samateur Hour. They do Drag Race videos, makeup videos, and everything you could possibly want. Make sure you click the bell, hit the notifications, leave a comment down below, like them, subscribe to them on Twitter, follow their Instagram, I don't know, send them DMs, and support them on Patreon. Bye! Love you!
Cool. So listen to Rock'em and subscribe, and let's get started. Alright, so first things first, I want to start with the queens entering back into the workroom, where they find Patty Pam Pam's message. Madame Madness wipes it off. There's a moment where Abby and Janie seem to make up. I'm not 100% sure if that was 100% genuine. So we'll see how that proceeds without in the future of this episode. Then they de-drag. That was about it really for that day. Then it's a new day in the workroom. They have to do a mini challenge where they have to get into quick drag and do mini games for Queen's Day. It's King's Day, but they're doing it for Queen's Day. And they do something putting nails in a jar. They do eating cake or bread off of hanging off a rope, and I think there's one more, but anyways, the winners of that are Cetogene and Madame Madness. So Madame Madness and Cetogene get to pick their teams for the main challenge. Madame Madness gets to go first, and she picks Janie, Abby, and Megan. So it's Madame Madness, Janie, Jacque, Abby, oh my god, and Megan Schoenbrood. And then Cetogene picks Envy, Chelsea Boy, and Mama Queen. So those are the two teams. I feel like Cetogene kind of has a pretty good advantage because, in my opinion, she picked the queens who are standing out but for better reasons. Anyways. So they assign roles, and then they go in, because it's an acting challenge, I should specify, and then they go record their acting in their soap opera videos, and there were a few standouts for me. Mama, Cetogene, and Chelsea Boy were standouts for good reasons. I thought Chelsea Boy was super funny. I thought Cetogene was just, oh, I love Cetogene and everything she does. I'm just being honest with you guys. And then, I also thought, I thought Envy did a good job too. She just didn't stand out as much, I think. Just, it might have been because her role was semi-smaller than the rest. And then some queens stood out for bad reasons. For me, those were Abby, Megan, and Janie. I didn't think Janie was that great. I think she kind of faded in. Megan was just, she was okay. I thought she did a good job. She just, I think she could, she's done better. Especially in the previous week, I think she did better with the gym exercise challenge. Abby, I think, just kind of faded away because they would give her notes and she wouldn't necessarily take them the best way possible. So she just kind of faded, in my opinion, at least. So that was the main challenge. They find out that they're going to have to do a runway with the coat, the person who came in to help them with their acting challenge, is going to be a judge. So then they come in the next day to get ready for the runway. Madame Madness is rushing to get her outfit ready, gluing things onto a jacket. People are kind of saying, oh, what is she doing? This is weird. And then also people were kind of like, oh, Chelsea Boy's trying to do like a quote-unquote fishy drag, which is the whole thing. I'm not getting into that right now. But anyways, so they get ready. Envy has a nice moment where she talks about her family, her past, and why she decided to move to the Netherlands, why she lives there. And then they go on the runway. So for me, some really good runways were Envy. I really, really liked the reveal moment. I thought that was super cool. How she went from being a cloud to being the sun. I thought that was a really, really nice runway. Oh, runway theme is nature related. Another good one to me was Chelsea Boy. I really liked the wind aspect, how it looked like she was blowing in the wind. I thought that was really cool. And also, yeah, Mama Queen was fine. I liked the idea behind it. I liked all the tattoos. I thought those were cool. I just think it seemed kind of small on the main stage, to me at least. But if you have a different opinion, let me know down below. So the meh ones were, Jenny. I mean, I got what she was going for with the water theme. I just think she could have done it somewhat better. But I didn't hate it. I thought it was a good runway, just not my favorite. And Mama was kind of meh to me. Some of the bad runways to me were, Abby. I just think, it was obviously a lot of flowers around her face. I'm putting pictures over here. But it kind of felt like the bottom was forgotten about, in my opinion. Madame Madness was not my favorite runway again. I got what she was going for and I liked it. I just think it could have been done better in a way that would be, just stepped up a little bit. I think she could step it up a decent amount and could have done better with it. I didn't really understand the boots. I don't know, maybe that's just me. The jacket kind of didn't really make a whole lot of sense to me. I mean, I got what she was going for, but I think it could have been done much better. And also, Megan just felt like she was wearing so much that it was swallowing her. Also, the pinwheels on her, where her boobs were, felt weird to me. I understood what she was going for with that. I just think it could have been done much better. It wasn't my favorite runway by any means. Anyways, so now we get to the judging. They really liked the safe queens. Sorry, let me restart. The safe queens were Envy and Janie, which I personally would have put Envy in the top, but that's just me, because that runway, I think she deserved to be on the top. And Janie made sense to me to be safe. She was just kind of faded there. She was there, but she didn't do super great in either thing, in my opinion. The tops were Cetogene, Chelsea Boy, and Mama Queen. And the bottoms were Madame Madness, Abby, Oh My God, and Megan Schoenbrut. In the end, Mama Queen won. I don't personally agree with this, but I mean, hey, that's their decision, it's not mine. These are just my opinions. And Sarah Jean and Chelsea Boy were safe. And then Fred Cult talked to each of the three bottoms, and Madame Madness ended up being safe. To me, I get it. A lot of the queens were upset though, because I felt like her runway was just super last minute and she didn't really put much of thought into it. So a lot of them were very upset that she got to be safe and scraped on through without having to lip sync. So anyways, now we get to the lip sync song between Megan and Abby. Abby was started stretching beforehand, so she was getting, you could tell she was getting ready to do some stunts. And then Megan would just didn't do as much. When it came to the actual lip sync, Abby was doing a whole bunch of flips. She was dancing around, doing things, and it felt like Megan was, she wasn't just standing there, but she didn't really do as many different, like, exciting tricks, if you want to call it that. Anyways, in the end, Megan Schoenbrut ended up going home this week. So I'm sorry, Megan, I feel you, I feel bad for you, but it was her time, I think, to go. I'm interested to see who goes home next week. If Madame Madness continues on the scale, I think she needs to go home. Continues at this rate, sorry. And I think Abby, I think, will be safe for a few more weeks at least. I think next it's probably going to be Madame Madness, and then we'll see when it comes to future episodes. I'm curious to see if they are going to do a Snatch Game or not. I want to see a Snatch Game because I always love Snatch Game. But anyways, yeah, that's bringing us to the end of this video. If you liked it, make sure to like this video. Comment down below what you thought of my review, what you think about the episode, and how you perceived it. Also, just if you like the video, let the YouTube algorithm know and like it and comment and engage with this video. And subscribe if you haven't already. Like I said, my birthday is coming up in 5 days. I'm going to be 23. Let's go. And yeah, I think that's it. I'll see y'all in the next one. Bye, guys.